the weather this time of year in the South? Perfect. Fall football weather. And we've got the roof wide open here at Mercedes-Benz Stadium in the heart of Georgia. Today, week 12 of the NFL season is upon us, and we've got a good one in store, as it'll be the Minnesota Vikings taking on the Atlanta Falcons. The final playoff push is upon us. It's week 12 of the NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. We'll see a return here from the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Start on the ground with Pierce. And not a whole lot to speak of there, so bring him down shy of the 20. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down. This defense for the Vikings, they were very good last week in the win over New Orleans.
Yeah, and what stood out to me on tape, the way they were flying to the football. So that tells me that they've got all their assignments down, and they're playing with extreme confidence.
Here's second and 8. That's taken in by Palmer. And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. 10 yards there and a first down for the Falcons. The Falcons had 5 and 6 to start play. And they coming on a pretty good roll here, winners of 3 straight.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
They'll bring a receiver in motion right. First and 10, it's Pierce. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right of the yard.
And that's right here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of this caliber who runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
From the 38 now, here's second down of the yard. Another carry for Pierce. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Atlanta.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Pierce gets this one running right. Down to about the 45. Hey, look at this defense for the Vikings. They find themselves just a couple of spots outside of the top 10 defending the pass, number 12 in the league.
And while teams don't like to talk about it, they're pretty proud of their rankings. But this ranking is going to be put to the test today because they're going up against a top 5 passing offense in this one.
Second and 6. Out wide for Palmer. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
It's a gain of 4. Makes it 3rd and 2.
Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. They'll look to throw. And he's going to have the Falcons first down. It's a gain of 6 that time on 3rd and 2.
Bison. 18 reps. 18 reps.
to throw now on first down. His throw incomplete.
Well, momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
Here's second and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. It's caught. He's brought down to the red zone at the 18 after a gain of 18. First and 10. This is what you want to see from your rookie quarterback on an opening drive, Charles. He looks cool, he looks calm, he looks collected in marching them down the field.
And Brandon, I just think the game continues to change and evolve because we're calling these guys rookies. But you know, they're getting the football so much at a younger level now, way more so than what we saw when guys came into the league when you and I came through.
And also just the way in particular to him, Charles, how he handles himself in meetings. Just so professional, mature. Looks like he's been in the league 5 years.
Yeah, he cares about the game. He cares about his performance, and it's showing.
And you see that kind of advancing into this game, don't you?
You certainly do. And when you have a team that doesn't get too full of itself, even though they've won two games in a row, you get the end result that we saw there, that nice opening drive, because they're sharp, they're focused, and they're locked into everything that they're doing.
Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And he'll elect not to run with it. A fair catch will move this out to the 25-yard line. Watson on first down. That's complete. Down the right sideline. And he steps out of bounds, but not before he gets inside the 35. A big play there for Minnesota. 43 yards.
Usually in this spot, you'd hear an offensive coordinator saying, don't feel like you've got to get this all back at once. But here, they give up the opening touchdown and say, no time like the present to show what we can do, too. And that's big yardage on their initial play from scrimmage.
And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
From the 29, here's second down and 7. Touchdown on the year, and the Vikings are able to match the opening drive touchdown against them with one of their own.
Yeah, they would have been happy with a first down, but this is even better. Once he's past the marker, it's cream cheese from there, and he bumps it to the outside, and it's just going to run away from defenders on his way toward the pylon.
extra point right down the middle, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
As a former defensive back, I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now, Ben. Let's give credit where it's due, because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
Yeah, because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football. Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete. Hey, look at this defense for the Vikings. They find themselves just a couple of spots outside of the top 10 defending the pass, number 12 in the league.
So prepping for this game, I kept asking myself the question, what's keeping this group from being top 10 in the league against the pass?
And?
Too many mistakes, especially little mistakes. And those add up into big mistakes add up into points against you. Recommitting themselves to the task at hand and forcing a three and out and giving the ball back to their offense.
It's taken to the 26. It's a return of 5 following a punt of 42 yards. And it will be Vikings ball, first and 10. Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, well, a two-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs, so they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. Now second and 3. Second down, they're running here. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. Over back at the 36. This will be a loss of 3, and now a much tougher third down moment. That makes third down a lot more interesting.
It certainly does. How about the example of situational football there and his ability to think the play through? Second and short, not anticipating a passing play, sold out and made a great tackle, which brings up third down. Scared me a little bit because he's not daunted. Just got right back up, showed some confidence, and picked up a first down with his very next run.
On first and 10, Watson. Complete. Jefferson the target. Calling a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be second down.
Justin Jefferson. It's a pickup of 6. Brings up second and 4 at their 49-yard line.
Set. solid stick on it. And a strong run there as he'll take this all the way down to the 35. 52 yards rushing for him now on just six carries to this point.
Although his reputation as a speedy runner precedes him, it's always fun to watch him work.
It is eye-opening, isn't it? Because when you see him get the ball and just go, in addition to that speed, it helps out his blockers. They don't have to hold blocks for long because he's just going to speed right past them.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he'll use a stiff arm for a little bit of leverage before he's taken down. A pretty good game. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Now that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've kind of hit the jackpot there.
Options galore here, second and a few inches. Watson now to throw. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. A gain of five, good enough for the first down. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
First down, Watson steps away to his left. And he rides him to throw that one away.
And their backs up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Now a second and 10. Sets him up nicely. First and goal. It was a pickup of 14.
Partner, there are strong running plays, and then there are plays where you simply outclass the defense, and we saw the latter there. They ran straight up the heart of that front for an excellent game and first down. Simply put, you've got to put up more of a fight defending the middle. Otherwise, this is going to be a long game.
DBs on the field, despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. Only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8.
We're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Defensively, they're in a bad spot.
But I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
The tight end in motion right. We've hit the two-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up. It's 7. They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. Hands it off out of the gun. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Call it a gain of 5. It's still a decent ways from the end zone now on fourth and goal. Now the Vikings will send out the special teams crew here for a field goal try. Right through. gets him down inside the five, but ultimately they set up for just the field goal.
And I have to think that if maybe they were a yard closer, that would have made their decision tougher, and I think they likely would have gone for it. But in this situation, they just decided to take the three, and I think it was a smart move.
At their own 25-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. As we eke closer and closer to intermission, Charles River, last time out there. They would love to get points here, especially if this is going to be their final possession of the first half.
Yeah, and this is what close games feel like, because the pressure is on both sides, but sometimes the pressure is a little bit higher on the team with the slight edge, because they're trying to hold on to that, trying to increase it. Let's see how this one continues.
So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line. They'll set up a throw. Guys, man, completion there. That's caught. And he's up into it at the 43.
You're going to see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And the lineman on the other side has got it. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. The pocket collapsed around him. I know we talk about it a lot, but a QB has to have that sixth sense, doesn't he?
He really does, and I know of one team at one point was training their quarterback with that time frame, and anytime he didn't get rid of the ball within the right amount of time, they would blow a horn or blow a whistle to show him this is what that time is, just what you're talking about.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts. They'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half.
Well, that's an excellent way to get the pass rush activated. The first sack of the game for them comes on the first play of the drive, and it makes it very tough for the opponent to pick up a first down now, playing behind the sticks.
Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. To throw is Watson. Pressure too great, and he goes down once more. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Back-to-back sacks have this place in a frenzy as they line up again, third and long. From the gun, they'll try to run it, and they'll get it down here to the 43. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout, and with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe.
Charles, even as long field goals become more and more common, this is still very rarefied air. Only just over 20 field goals have been kicked from 60 yards or further, and you can add his name to the list now.
And as calm as he tried to present himself, there's no doubt there were some nerves as he lined up to attempt that kick. But once the ball was snapped, he just swept the leg and boom, over the crossbar.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. A slim deficit here in a one-possession game. Not much time left, obviously. We'll see if they can march this down the field, at least get three. Into a double team, that's intercepted. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line.
He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw, because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
So first and 10 now from the 30. They'll bring a receiver in motion left. After the interception, here's Watson. They're looking for Jefferson, but this is intercepted. Picked off by J.C. Jackson. And the Falcons are going to take possession as they got it at the 42-yard line. And the defense got on the football with an interception. They trot out their trials in the very first play. They'll get the football right back.
Brandon, I almost expect you coming like an auctioneer. We've got two, we got two. Do I hear three? Remember, it was two in a row. Would we hit three in a row?
Go.
Because these offenses, they got to be a little bit more careful as they go forward. These defenders, they're locked in and really focused.
Palmer going to go in motion left. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. That's complete to Palmer. Just shy of the 40. This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards. With that grab, he now sits at 200 for his career, and maybe more importantly, a first down.
Season.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Up to make the tackle, J.C. Jackson. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. Vikings have to like their position. They've got the lead. They get this football as well as we are back and underway for the second half. And that'll be a little too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone for a touchback here. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. They've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could go a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation and pick up those pass rushers, because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and 5. They'll bring a receiver in motion right.
Some
possession goes over here on the punt.
And it will be Falcon football.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate to get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. Running it out of the gun with Pierce. Inside his face mask there, the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone came around with a lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. First down, here's the run with Cook. And he'll get what he can up the middle, 3 yards, and that'll bring up second down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. 3 yard pickup brings up second and seven at the Vikings 30-yard. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time this time. Marcus May with a pick. And the Vikings are going to take possession here at their own 16-yard line. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now 3 interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How'd things turn out for him?
I think, okay, he's a guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
They'll start this drive out of the game. He finds a little bit of room, enough for 4 yards. It'll be second down.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
To throw on second is Watson. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll be knocked to the turf right there as he gets it up to the 43. 23 yards the pick up there.
Well, partner, they've used him quite well out of the backfield in this one. And here's another nice example. They set up the screen, and he's able to pick his way downfield for a nice gain there.
Down, it's Watson. Heavy rush, and down he goes. It's the corner blitz that got him. J.C. Jackson with his sack.
He already did his primary job with an interception earlier, but here he gets a chance to be a pass rusher and takes on the challenge of blitzing and makes another big play. That's something to file away and maybe break out later in this one or in a future game.
That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Now Watson. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't give it back in one play. Sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one. Weren't able to do so.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And they'll bring it up here right at the 40-yard
good effort there, 9 yards, but not enough. We'll likely see the punt team now on fourth down. The Vikings send out their punter as he'll kick it away for the second time. 46 on his first kick, this one in that neighborhood as well. Taken about the 16. They'll call this a 41-yard punt, 7 on the return. And the Falcons will be taking over first and 10. Out there for their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Ball on the 27. Here's a second down and 6. Back to throw here. Right back to Cook for another completion. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4-yard pickup leaves him with 3rd and 1. Here now, 3rd and 1 yard. They'll run it. Here's Cook.
Shed a nice tackle on that play.
Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Palmer. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And they'll be faced with a 3rd and 1. Pierce will try to pick it up. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. So the scoring dried up here in the third. Nothing that quarter for either side. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. From Viking territory now, they'll come up 1st and 10 at the 49-yard line. They're going to look to throw. Drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's 2nd down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Another throw on 2nd down, and this one incomplete as well.
I like the look of that play right from the beginning. I thought he should have seen the coverage that was there, tried to force it in. That one, he's fortunate, just fell incomplete.
This drive, they're a perfect 2 of 2 on 3rd down conversions, but they need a full 10 yards here. Now
They'll look to throw. He's going to rifle one deep left side.
Because you've got the lead in the fourth, it doesn't mean you have to play it safe. I like the aggressive play call there to push it downfield. That time, it didn't work out.
One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. That's incomplete. They could not convert, and they turn it over. The Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And this defense will take over right near midfield at the 49-yard line. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Their defense forced the turnover on downs. They've got the lead. They're in good shape, but can't go into a shell here, right? Still got to be careful.
Yeah, because he's still a long way away from kneel down time. So you got to work on getting first downs. Keep the sticks moving. Keep the clock going. That's a kill. Don't turn it over.
Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Run blitz there defensively. Something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
In motion right is Addison. Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Here's Watson now on second down. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A gain there of 21 yards.
For as many sacks as this defense has, you can understand their willingness to try and get upfield and get another. So what a really smart play call here to use their aggression against them. Go with the screen, and they're able to get the first down.
Watson. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked up by Jesse Bates. And the Falcons are right back in this football game. A critical error there. And a tight game of the fourth.
All you talk about is taking care of the ball, especially with the lead here in the fourth quarter. Turning it over. Now the door is open for the opposition.
Just in general, when you're passing in the fourth quarter with a lead, no matter what point, you got to be super careful.
Got to be careful, and sometimes you can be so careful that you end up running yourself into an error.
Shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
A run for Pierce out of the gun, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up, and now they're in the hurry up.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and eight.
Here's second and eight. Tackle is made at the Vikings 16.
certainly had an outstanding second half, haven't they? I know they just gave up a first down there, and for the offense, they're hoping that that's something that they can jumpstart with and maybe start to move the ball a little bit better. But it's been tough sledding for them here the entire second half.
They look to throw now on first down.
Screen to the running back, because they understand you can only go to the well so many times in a game without the defense starting to anticipate the call.
Second and 10. Looking to throw. That's underneath to Pierce. He's down inside the 10 to the 8. On a gain of 8. Right there, he rose to the occasion late in a close game.
It's something he thought about, dreamed about, and worked on throughout his career. Because in these types of situations, he wasn't going to allow extra coverage to keep him from getting the football. To stop in the run, and that's a nice job there getting the safeties involved in run support.
Okay, ready?
From the two now, second and goal. Pierce. Start this drive out on the ground. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
From the gun, he'll hand this off. Less than 2 minutes to play. Down to the wire we go in a one-point game. Plenty of time and 2 timeouts still at their disposal. First and 10 here. Watson now, going to run the option right. And he's going to get out of
bounds with the first down. So that's going to double their pleasure for sure. They get the first and save a timeout.
You know, as a defensive guy, I don't normally do this, Brandon, but a tip of the cap to the offensive coordinator. Design quarterback run at this stage of the fourth quarter when I expected him to throw the ball, and he got a first down.
Yeah, trailing this stage of the fourth quarter. Picked up the first, stopped the clock, too.
Yeah, sometimes there's some guts in play calling when you go against the grain because you know you could easily be criticized if it doesn't work out.
This is first and 10. Watson to throw. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. It is incomplete.
It seems that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they got trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Here comes second down.
So they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
The sound reverberating here in the dome. This is third down. Two timeouts still available in this final minute. It's first and 10 now. Get the timeout call. What a finish. We're down to 4 seconds to go in this football game.
game's going to come down to the right leg of their kicker. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. So on is their kicker, and it's down to this. 2 for 2 on the afternoon, and a third and a winner. Now flags come in before the kick. Clearly there was contact. Who was at fault? So it was the defense that jumped, and that'll move them 5 yards closer.
I wonder how they did it. What if they twitched a little bit up front, you know, a little subtle head movement that the officials didn't detect, but they got it done. Now they're 5 yards closer for their field goal attempt.
Now first and goal. Charles, that drive was perfect, methodical, executed so well, and they grabbed that lead with almost no time left for a last gasp from the other side. Kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 32-yard line.
Here's first and 10.
GG's, get off my field.
Minnesota, they keep pacing the playoff race as they move to 8-3 on the